What's up guys, this is SP Architect. ARCHICAD 24 was released, let's look at what are the news. According to the description, there are 5 key areas they focused. These are change management in design, project management, and collaboration. Integrated structural analysis workflows in analysis engaging, client presentation, visualization, and increased productivity by automation in documentation. Model comparison feature allows you to manage client change requests with issue management tool. This was developed to make faster and easier design decisions for our projects. In this example, you will see a changing in the project, and as the team leader, you are going to validate that changing. You are going to control display of the changes by selecting some of them, and you can create suggestions to be using issue management later on. There are new interior objects, new beds, nightstands are available, and items you see in this video. These objects are parametric. They say you don't need to lose time by modeling furniture elements manually from scratch or money for expensive design libraries. We are going to be importing Revit families. These actions will allow us to reach more manufacturers' content. This option allows us without going through many conversion process and technique with 2D and 3D representation issues, as well as missing many product information. Another new is Paramo, which is kind of Grasshopper parametric modeling, is free and come with ARCHICAD 24. This add-on allows ARCHICAD 24 users create parametric GDL objects with a visual program interface. I tried this, but as they said, this is an alpha version and actually no need to use right now. There needs a lot of more. Since I couldn't find them, if you can find any secret helping website, you can comment down below. They will be worked as a simple library part and allows us to make facade variations as well. There is a new feature for MAP engineering. It didn't take my attention. Maybe it can be useful for brute interior designs. As you can see here, very complex MAP models can be made if you find enough time from your main designs. To do that, first we are going to import 2D drawing into our project and use them as reference. After that, we are going to model. As I said at the first, this can be useful for 3D visualization. The dark mode, choose your side, just a joke. This mode is an option for those with eye problems, but I like it much. But unfortunately, it is only for Mac users, not for desktop. They don't realize they are playing the wrong horse. Anyway, it's now fashion to switch dark mode for softwares, but kinda good thing in my opinion. AutoCAD used this for years. Other feature is polyline face editing. Intersection between polylines available. Intersection between walls and polyline is possible. And fill chamfer command for polylines. Issue management in Teamworks now available. It's now easier to follow evaluation of the project. You just right-click the issue and go for Add to New Issue. Afterwards, input your issue. Click Add. Now it's visible between team members. Let's jump into BIMx features. There are lots of BIMx features, but still it is not possible for desktops. This one only for iPads. Since the advanced data streaming technology, it's not possible to reach unlimited 3D model sizes. Therefore, it's also possible faster startup opening, nearly no time. In addition to do that, photorealistic view calculation was added. And finally, Smart Measure feature is available on the app. These are BIMx workflow new features. Direct publishing to transfer site, 5GB private storage with SSA, BIMx Web Viewer, update desktop app, share model via URL, real-time ambient occlusion effect, support of 3D connection and game controller navigation devices. Other feature is Python scripts. If you know to use Python scripts, you can use it in ARCHICAD for some automation. Here is an example. In this example, this script is going to change all of the IDs of the chairs automatically. Let's move on. New Residential Furniture Library brings your interiors to life. Let's look at what they are together. I opened ARCHICAD 24 first time, by the way. We are looking at this the first time together. If we look at these tools, there is a new tool here which is Equipment Tool. Let's just look through this new tool. I place something on the screen. I think this is about MEP system for mechanical engineering. There are parametric hotspots on this. We can pull out or pull into. I don't know what I am doing with this because I am an architect, and also this program was designed for architects, not for mechanical engineering. I think this is an unnecessary feature. Okay, I don't want to bother you. Let's be moving on other object types. If you right click here, we will see toolbar selection box. There is MEP engineering toolbox as you can see. You can open this up or close down. If you open this, you will see the settings here. And this routing tools can be opened. We can make pipes and similar designs. You click the start routing and click on the screen. After finishing our architectural designs, this routing tool might be useful. If engineers use this, we can intersect these pipes with our model. But I don't think so. They are a bit lazy, I think. They just loaded this workup to architects, which is too annoying. Who is going to teach engineers using this program? Okay. Anyway, we can see additional options and settings here. There are different profile types for different purposes. We can use exhaustive air system like this one, or we can just go for undefined systems. By the way, these pipes are not only go straight, they can go up or go different diagonal directions. Anyway, let's be moving on to the other new amazing object types. I have seen very nice new models for interior scenes. For example, these chairs. These chairs, new chairs, and I think they can be useful. We can gain some time for interiors. You can see these different ottomans. There was only one ottoman before which was coarse. This type has also different parameters. Let's look through here. I cannot see additional new settings. There is only a new leg parameter here. We can use these leg styles. Click these arrows. Now we are at bed shop. I wonder if I want to buy an orthopedic mattress. Maybe there are some useful selections here. We can check, uncheck this mattress. I don't know who wants to uncheck this one. We've got a bed on the 3D. There is ottoman under the bed. Drag to here. We can change its size, of course. This is an object. If you want more about objects in ARCHICAD, I'll place a card here. I'm opening these pillows up, but as you can see, they are very coarse and ugly. You just don't have to care much. Because I'm going to show you a surprise for these clothes. Oh my god, just look at these bed canopies. They are awesome. Can you see this curtain? Are they selectable? I don't think so. Maybe there is a parameter in the settings. But we can change this fence parameter. This one also has headboard parameter. We click the arrow. There we go. We have parameters for the curtains. I think I could use these curtains for interiors. I could set up curtain angle and export these objects. Afterwards, just delete others. Let's look through two tables. This one looks good. Also, all of them are looking good. Let's click this arrow. We can see panel styles here and knob styles also can be changed. For classical, you can use this one. instead of metal knob, you can use these contemporary holders. There are hole holdings also. Circle one, elliptic one, or rectangle. I think they incorporate this to all new objects. Let's move to sofas. I think they are quite successful. If I click this one, a bevel line appears. If there are new settings here, okay, there aren't any new here. Let's just place this one and this one. And these are very nice. We can use this with TV motion, which is awesome. We can switch between this and this, and there are legs options here, as you can see. And I like that color. Let's select this, drag this hotspot here. It's not scaling, it changes parametric. You can explore this sofas. Let's go to the surprise. Under the decoration tab, there are blankets and pillows. Very nice, isn't it? There are very useful options here. We can place this onto beds or into open cabins. You can see this clothes here. I drag to here on the bed. We just need to scale this up and change the rotation. How are the other clothes? Let's try this. Click OK. For example, I'm gonna bring to here, rotate, move to here. If we can bring this to corner. Okay, anyway, it will drop a nice effect. And also we have this nice folded clothes we can put on top of each other. Ctrl plus D, hold the shift key and copy onto it. You just copy it here and there we go. For the last blanket sample, I'm gonna use this one onto this bed. Okay, here, let's select this one and move. You align this corner, go to F3. We ignore this bottom part. You just drag this a little to here. Then you scale this up to side. There we go. You can just follow the same steps for the pillows. You place the pillow and rotate the head part like this. You place additional pillows for nice interiors. I assigned some red material on that. Let's take a render. I think it looks nice. As a new model, there are glass options, trays, vases, and much more. I leave the rest for you. I think that's all it for ARCHICAD 24 for me. I hope you also like new version. Keep exploring, comment down below, like and subscribe. Bye!